Hello, my name is Dominic. I'm going to show you something I've been tinkering with lately. It's a user mode driver for Luxeed's LED keyboard for Mac OS X. I've got an ordinary Intel Mac running Leopard, and here is the Luxeed keyboard. So my hands don't get in the way during the demo. I also have here an Apple Bluetooth keyboard that I'll be typing on. So now I'm just going to plug the keyboard in. So the keyboard lights up better, I'm going to actually dim the lights here. This is the software. It's a Cocoa application called Keyboard Thema, and you apply effects to your keyboard by choosing from this list of available effects and dragging and dropping them into this list of effects that'll be applied to your keyboard. And you have to check the visible checkbox to make the keyboard light up, and then you can configure the settings of each effect. So this effect called Conway's Life, which is the game of life, as a color. That's what you see applied to the keyboard here. And you can change the color of the life effect. And you can't see this on the video, but the keyboard reacts instantly as you pick a color. The effect as it's displayed on the keyboard updates, which is why there's no on-screen keyboard, because you can just look at the keyboard on your desk. Now I'll turn Conway's Life off and drag over what might be my favorite effect. It's called the heat map. And this is basically the spark effect. So when you press a key, the key you press will glow briefly. I'll just pull up text edit so I can type something. Oh, the effect isn't visible. Make it visible. And now type. You can also make multiple effects visible at once, which is what I'm doing here. Layering the heat map in red over the game of life in white. This effect is a plasma, which is periodic functions on top of Perl and noise. And by tweaking the sliders down here, you can get a lot of interesting visual effects. I'm just going to make a basic rainbow effect here, which we get by putting the red, green, and blue all at different offsets in the periodicity. Now we're going to change gears and talk about programming the keyboard yourself. Here I've dragged across the AppleScript effect, which doesn't have any settings. But if you run an Apple script outside of Keyboard Thema, like through Apple's script editor that I've just brought up here, you can program each of the keys individually, however you like. This is an example script that is also on the website. It asks the mail application for the number of unread items in mail. And if there are any unread items, it'll set the squiggle key to be bright green. This record over here is a red, green, blue triple. You can also program effects in JavaScript by dragging the JavaScript effect onto your list of applied effects. And with this effect, you get a little JavaScript editor and you write your JavaScript right in keyboard Thema. There's a log window at the bottom, which is useful for debugging. So I'll just demonstrate a simple script that just writes something to the log, hit play, and you'll see hello world appears in the log. Obviously you can do a lot more by writing a RGBA record into the keys hash. You can set the color of individual keys. So here I'm going to make the G key bright red. And to get your script to run, you just need to toggle the play button. Now we're going to do something much more interesting with JavaScript. This is the Yahoo Finance page, and as you can see, if you type a few ticker symbols into their little get quotes search thing, you can see the daily change for a bunch of different stocks. So ahead of time, I've done some digging through the HTML of this page, and I've written a little JavaScript that can, it downloads the page and then it uses a regular expression you see at the top here to dig out the ticker symbols and the color of that cell that has the day's change in it. So now I'm just going to fill in the query string with a couple of interesting stocks, Google, Microsoft, Sony, Nintendo. And then when you run this, when the page download is complete, it loops over all of the matches of that regular expression, pulls out the symbols, and then it pulls out the HTML attribute of their color. And here, we're setting the key, which is the first letter of the ticker symbol, to that color. So thanks very much for watching the demo. If you're interested in trying out the software yourself, go to www.macledkeyboard.com and sign up for an email when it's ready. Thanks.